So, Siddhant, why the switch from healthcare to food business, and why shifting? What were some of the obstacles that you came across which changed the
Okay.
journey?
The shift was very simple. I was diagnosed with lupus in the final year of my medicine. Lupus essentially is an autoimmune disorder that you have a hyperactive immune system. So your body doesn't differentiate between what is infectious and what is self and keeps attacking self. So because of that, I had quite a few health complications due to that. That's when I had to start taking a lot of steroids. And the steroids essentially were to weaken my own immune system so that my own immune system stops fighting against me. Now, with a weak immune system, I cannot be going to a municipal hospital because simple things like tuberculosis can be contracted very easily. That's when the shift came about in my thinking that probably for the next 3 or 4 years, I would not be permitted to be around infectious people or people with communicable diseases. I need to think of something else. That's when the entire scene with Devaj happened. And more than it, it's more like I was at the right place at the right time rather than having this cocky attitude that no, wow, I thought of this company and this was my idea. I don't think it was. It was a very collective effort, but I was definitely at the right place at the right time. So I found my escape from medicine very quickly. Then there was no turning back. So this is how it happened. And difficulties, not so much. I've always been a stubborn child. From the parents' point of view, I just didn't listen to them when. So they were concerned, right? Because I did go back to doing my internship while Food Darzi was running. So I used to find these hacks on how to attend internship as little as possible and have as little as possible as patient contact. So while doing this, my parents obviously weren't happy with the fact that I'm not going to become a doctor. Like, I did finish my medicine, but I wasn't going to be a practicing doctor. Well, I come from three generations of doctors. So my dad and my granddad were extremely unhappy. But as time passed, as they saw that, there is some solidarity in Food Darzi, I think all they wanted was for me not to be ambiguous in my own head. They just wanted me to make a decision. And once the decision about Food Darzi was made and we were flourishing, we were working hard, then I think the parental pressure to completely just went away. And apart from that, yes, challenges will always be there. Yeah, apart from that, challenges in terms of running a startup are always there. Like our kitchens caught fire once, and we've lost multiple clients in that occasion, and our chefs leave. And basically, the basic hustle of getting a startup from the ground up. So, nothing to really pinpoint on, but I think initial challenges are just changing your mindset. Yeah, like I haven't ever seen a doctor who was my age, and I was 22 at that point in time. So I was just getting into something which I didn't know too much about. Like I can lie to people and say that, yeah, my dream was to become a nutritionist and I knew everything about nutrition. But the fact of the matter is, no, doctors don't know shit about nutrition. And I had to learn everything from scratch, and it turns out I was good at it. So yeah, it's been a fun journey.
All right. So the next question is, we're seeing a lot of professionals like yourself, all right, doctors, nutritionists, even stylists, create content on social media channels and build their personal brand. So obviously you see, I'm not even going to ask you why, you see like such channels are a good platform for information transmission. So do you see social media actually play an important role in the future of healthcare in the coming years? And how?
Oh, I think the only see social media, not so much. Of course, the way things are going to change, yes, healthcare is going to become primarily online. Like a doctor's diagnosis is only going to be needed for the clinical signs that he has to perform on a patient. Apart from that, I think everything can be switched to online. From a social media perspective, I think just making people aware. Yeah. Like, see, social media is a very selfish space. You can lie to people and tell them that I'm doing it for the community and I'm doing it for the greater good, but stop lying to people. You like the fame, you like the money it brings along with it, and you like the fact that you're able to help people. If the first two weren't around, the third one will automatically stop existing. So I don't think it's going to change the way, but yes, people will become more aware and you'll just have more famous doctors and nutritionists and things like that. So I personally don't believe that social media really makes that much of an impact, but that's exactly why I put in so much volume of content because if five people get influenced by one piece of content positively, only five people have gotten influenced by that one piece of content is why I put hundreds of pieces of content out because I, as an individual, am of those, thoda कि करना है यू नो बिकॉज यू गेट गुड मैसेजेस यू फील ग्रेट आई लव हैविंग अटेंशन अराउंड मी आई हैव बीन द बिगेस्ट अटेंशन सीकर ऑलवेज एंड दिस जस्ट फ्यूल्स एवरीथिंग सो देन इट्स अ गुड फीलिंग दैट व्हेन पीपल सेंड यू मैसेजेस दैट यू नो आई सॉ योर वीडियोस एंड इट रियली हेल्प्स एंड दे स्पेसिफाई व्हाट हेल्प्स बिकॉज अदरवाइज पीपल कैन बी यू नो दे कैन बी गिविंग यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स ऐसे दैट बस सामने है तो बोल देने का but they specify what part of what video actually helped and that sort of fuels you further into believing that you are making a difference and I think one thing what every individual wants to do is make a difference but most people don't have an avenue of doing it and now that I've found an avenue I don't think I'm going to leave it.
For you, what do you think, Sidhan? How important is it for a founder of a startup to build his personal brand, something that you've been very successful at?
It's very important, yeah, because one, it gives your brand a lot of credibility, as I mentioned. People actually, when they search a brand, your name pops up with them. If they find you credible, automatically you've got one extra tick onto your brand. Part two is you can cross-sell on your platform. Like I have twice the amount of followers Food Darzi does, right? So whatever Food Darzi is doing, I'll be able to cross-sell that on my platform also. My followers will also be engaged with them. Number three, performance marketing based. My audience can also be used as a retarget audience for Food Darzi ads. So that way, sales-wise, it definitely helps. But again, being honest, Food Darzi sales are too high for my sales to actually be a contributory factor. I think over the next 5 or 6 years, if I probably reach like 2-3 million followers, then yes, I can be an active part of Food Darzi's customer acquisition strategy or cost. But right now, it's more about the credibility. And it's been a year since I've been making content. So you can't tangibly put a finger on it and say it's you who's, you know, gotten us all the sales, but over time it will, like, we'll become synonymous with each other.
Good that you spoke about performance marketing in your previous question, because we were actually, yeah, since we're in a marketing cell, we're going to ask you questions about marketing.
Definitely, now. Definitely.
So can you walk us through the creative process for your content generation?
Of a Food Darzi, is performance marketing based content generation or my content generation?
Your content generation, and then tell us what you do differently for Food Darzi.
Okay. So my content generation is very simple. There are certain cohorts under which you need to create content. So there's sex, there's health, there's nutrition, there's medicine, there are facts, there's some trending stuff and entertainment. Bakwas jo hota hai, all of that shit where you have to dance and shake your ass in front of the camera. So your content buckets are divided majorly into these, and then you populate them with topics. Now, a large part of your content is going to come from your audience, because they send you DMs, they comment on your current piece of content, and they tell you what they want to hear. Now, you sort of analyze what a lot of people want to hear, but make it extremely massy, because only massy content works. Like if I say the most interesting thing, but it's not massy, it just tanks majorly. And unfortunately, on Instagram, once you have one piece of content that tanks, it negatively impacts the engagement of the piece of content right after it also. So it's very important to make pieces of content that work consistently, because your engagement rate keeps fluctuating, your engagement fluctuates, and then less people can see you and so on and so forth. It's quite toxic on your head, because sometimes I've just been making repeat contents. Now, 1 year ago, something that touched 1 million views, I've just picked it up again, changed the word, then put it out again, because I know that's so massy it works, which is not the way it should be done, right? Like I want to be putting out things that I want to talk about, but not a lot of them work. So this is essentially how you create your content. You make your cohorts, you populate them with topics, you make them more massy, and then you write them in the most massiest candid way possible, so that you can be yourself. Like I don't want to be one of those who just, you know, sit like that. Yes, I do wear a blue scrubs wala of uniform, yeah, kind of a thing, because that's become my identity. Like I've had so many people come up to me who don't remember who I am, but they remember I'm the blue guy who comes and says things about health. So that was also important. Like I did that very, very consciously, because I had seen a lot of doctors abroad doing this. Nobody in India had still started doing it. And I started another 100 doctors in India who do the same thing, which is great. But my identity as the guy in the blue coat has helped me. Now, probably eventually I'm just going to start wearing normal clothes, because people keep passing comments that you're not a practicing doctor. I have no answer to that, but theek hai. So that's how I create content. From a Food Darzi's perspective, everything is performance. Like social media does exist, yes, but not a very large part of sales are not generated from social media. Like when we started social media, we thought that, you know, we'll put our post on Food Darzi and a lot of people are going to be waiting to sign up. It doesn't work that way. Brands' engagement rates are extremely low. You're barely reaching any people the moment you start spending money on Instagram and Facebook. from a creative process of how the performance marketing at Foodlazy works, we do know what kind of creatives work for various audiences, whether the audience is in which city, which age group, which demographic, what interest is it, whether their car brand interest, like you've got multiple interests, right? Car brand, shoes, expensive footwear, health, keto, low carb. So what kind of an interest bucket is going to be vibing with what kind of a creative? We already have that written. And then we do upper niche, like 19-20, 20-21 wala experimentation, then we change the creatives around a little bit and then we run them as ads. And obviously, we've got certain rules of ourselves made about performance marketing. When you need to start a new ad, when you need to stop a new ad, what the cost per result needs to be, how many forms are okay for an ad to get in, how long do you want an ad to be going on for? So yeah, it's complex. Like Anirudh and Anik, both the co-founders, they personally handle performance marketing because that is the bread and butter of every social media based startup. Like there is no other way to acquire customers. Word of mouth, of course, is quite strong, but word of mouth can only take you so far. In order to acquire customers outside of the people you've already served, performance marketing is the key. And in the future, in the next 2 or 3 years, the space is going to become so saturated that a marketing executive who cannot do performance marketing will be outdated. Because yes, creativity will exist, content will exist, but eventually all content will have to be driven by money behind it for it to actually have real reach. Otherwise, you just create viral content, which is not something you can bank on. So performance marketing is definitely going to become way more important in the next 2 or 3 years.